R.I.P. It served me well. Wow.
What's in the box? Alright guys, what is up? Welcome back. I've been gone for so long, feels like it's been actually 2 months, but I'm finally back. I'm so pumped to make more videos. I mean, I've been uploading here and there, but I miss my studio. So I am back and you should be expecting 2 videos a week at least. Alright, so in this video I just want to share my experience, how I repaired, well, let's just say I crashed it first, Mavic Pro 2. How much it was, what was the damage, how does the process go, what was my overall experience, you know? Let's start how I crashed it. So when I was back visiting my family in Ukraine, I was flying over this bridge. It was super cool, and as always, I already got all my shots, but I'm like, oh, let me do one more, and I swap out the battery flat out, and it was totally my error because I turned off obstacle avoidance, and I do it a lot now because I want to fly through some narrow spaces, objects, fly through, and I don't want the drone to stop me from doing that. And then I forget to turn it back on. So what happened is I of course forgot to turn back the obstacle avoidance back, and I was flying around this bridge and I was flying sideways. So here's the bridge and I'm flying sideways, and obviously I did not see the trees on the side and I just hit the trees. So the coverage just got disconnected and I was like, okay, probably just bad signal, and I was trying to get it back, try to find it, and it passed like a minute, two, five, and I realized it's gone. So I was on top of this, kind of like a hill, I'm not gonna call it a mountain, but there is a park that you can go down through and it's kind of like zigzag and sidewalk. So I ran down trying to find a drone because I figured it's either in the water, or if I'm lucky I might actually find it, because if I find it I can ship it to DJI and at least I'll spend some money and get it back, otherwise it's gone completely. I saw a couple of photographers and they were doing sunrise shoot. By the way, this was like 6 a.m. I was like, have you guys seen the drone? And they are like, yeah, it's literally just hit that tree and I just fell, it just fell down like a rock. Like, they show me exact location where it. So I ran up there and here's the video I shot on my phone.
Guys, this morning has been so beautiful, but this is my drone. R.I.P. It served me well. Wow.
And that is the condition I found the drone in. So as you can see from the video, it is all beat up. The arms are broken, the camera is broken, the gimbal is broken, the battery just flew out. Then you can say it got water damaged. I mean, it's not as bad, but I've been just sitting here and there's running water, so I don't know. I mean, it looked really bad. I shipped out to DJI the drone, so it's pretty easy process. You go to their website, you open up a case, you put in the serial number, and you send the drone. So I took off the propellers. So the condition they get the drone in, I mean, what they get is what you get back. So you shouldn't be shipping the battery. And let's say if you don't ship the propellers with your drone, you're not going to get the propellers back. Unless you ship them the broken propellers, they'll charge you to fix the propellers to replace them and you'll get them back. Because that's what happened to me. I only shipped one broken propeller and that's the one they replaced. So the other ones are also broken and I don't have them right now. And here is the quote that I got from them. I was surprised because I've crashed drones before and the quotes were like $200-$300. I mean, it was not as much damage, but here it is. So as you can see from this email, I paid a bunch of little things, bunch of like plastic components, like arm, the vibration absorbent board is like $2, another one, lower upper module $12, middle frame module $14. I mean, these are all pretty cheap, but here where it gets pricey, the core board module, I figure it is the main motherboard, correct me if I'm wrong, and that is $339. That's where it got pretty expensive, and I wonder if that didn't have to be replaced, but it is what it is, because I feel like the drone was still working, it was still turning on, it was just the physical damage, but it doesn't matter. And then there's a repair service fee, which they charge too, which means they charge me for 2 hours, $130 an hour. That's $260 just for the labor. And it comes out to a whopping $760. and they only take PayPal. So if you don't have PayPal, I don't know, maybe you gotta get a PayPal and connect your Visa card or MasterCard or whatever. The new one costs about $14.59 if I'm not mistaken. I'm gonna put it down in the description so you can check it out. Also, I made a list of my favorite accessories that I use with a drone. I'll put them in the description so you guys could see what I use, what cases, what ND filters, all this good stuff that I use. You should definitely check it out. So the whole process takes about a week. I'd say 5 to 7 working days, because then you have to ship it out. Then it takes a good 2-3 days for them to do the quotation. And they update you on everything. They send you emails. Where is your drone? What is happening to it? And they even show me the photos of the drone. So they actually took the photos of the drone again and they showed me the actual damage, which was pretty cool. I thought I really liked the experience. They don't really take your drone and fix it. They actually sent you a brand new drone. Well, I guess it's a refurbished drone, but it looks brand new. You know, when you go to Apple Store and you swap out the phone, they give you a phone in another box. That is how your drone will look like with all brand new stickers. So it came in this box and I'm gonna show you what inside is. So here we go. As soon as we open the box, as you could see, I already opened it. You get some paperwork, flight safety guide. By the way, you can purchase DJI Care now as you got this new refurbished drone. Some notes about the repair, and they gave me these propellers, the ones that I actually sent them that were broken. So now I gotta get more propellers because the other ones are also broken, but I chose not to ship it to them. And then you get the drone in the bubble wrap, just like that. So here we are. The drone is pretty much brand new. All the stickers are still on it. It is refurbished slash brand new drone, and without the battery, of course, like I was saying. All the stickers are on it. I already checked it out and connected to my remote, and it works. It's a brand new drone. So it's not a bad, I'm super happy with the experience. Also, what they kind of upgraded when I got my drone first, it did not have this plastic. It's more of a little rubber thing that goes here. And when I had it before without it, it would scratch the top of the camera here. So now it does not do it because it has this rubber cover. So you'll put it back like that. You'll have to align it a bit and then it snaps. I wish. Okay, there it is. Snaps right back on and you're good to go. Well, that is it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you like this video. Subscribe for more videos like these every week. And I hope you don't crash your drone. And if you did, comment below your story, how much it cost you. I would really like to know how does DJI handles all these other drones and all these damages. It's pretty interesting to find out all these other stories that happen to other people. But hopefully you didn't crash your drone, and don't crash it. Don't turn off obstacle avoidance. And that is it for me. Peace out. See you next week. Peace.
Add it up.